Well, I'd like to thank the Academy. And I'd never have found success if it weren't for my dog. Fake it till you make it. Hi, I'm Stacey Sheesby, and welcome to the aka the Unfuckening Movement, where one step at a time, we literally start the healing process. On the healing process, as I've talked about in many of my other healing videos, I've talked about different aspects of self. Well, today I'm invoking the spirit very much of the star, because I realized as I watched back my last video how I had discounted or minimized myself as almost not having enough experience or enough education, as having nothing. Well, I do have experience and I do have education to back me up in what I'm talking about in this healing venture. And I should own that and be proud of it. Something that I'm definitely needing work on myself. So I'm going to fake it until I make it. Something else that I noticed is if I am minimizing or decreasing my value on my own projects, where else in my life have I minimized myself to the point of being an extra? An extra in my own life. Extras are very good at, could you go here, please? A little to the left. No, I need you to sit down. No, I'm afraid you're going to have to move a little bit. You're blocking the other person, right? So extras are very good at accommodating everybody else's needs. Most likely because they were trained to do that behavior from the time they were really young. They've been either raised in an environment with alcoholism or narcissism or a self-absorbed parent or an energy in the household where one person kind of stole all the energy and the focus had to be around them. So a child quickly learns to minimize self and place self in accommodating positions. Overly kind, how can I help? How can I figure this out? Because it's far better to be coming at a situation, controlling it, controlling the outcome of unpredictability. It gives you a sense of power in a powerless situation than it does to say, try to fight, but myself, I want, I need, learn at a young age to suppress that voice of self so far down that it almost doesn't exist. If you find yourself in a situation or with situations with people where, you know, you're constantly accommodating other people's needs, I don't mind what restaurant we go to. Oh, the vacation, it doesn't matter. You pick. No, I don't care. What message is that sending? It's sending, I don't care about you. You. That's shocking. That's shocking when you think about it. And when I think about it. And when I think about how many times I've shown up in other people's lives, cast as an extra. Hey, if I've had interactions with you in the past and you really kind of felt like that was an energy that was like I was presenting to you, I'd say the majority of people in my past have met me in my party girl phase. She was a fun one. But if I showed up in your life and you felt like, she's an extra. One doesn't take the time to get to know extras. You know, one's not really like overly caring and compassionate. So if in your relationship there's a really imbalance of power, you find yourself, you're the one that's always giving and giving and giving and not getting or getting and getting, there's an imbalance there. Somebody's getting to be a star in the show and somebody's being an extra. Well, I've decided for this girl, If I've shown up in the past and I presented myself as an extra, I apologize. That's not who I am. I'm Stacey Sheesby, and I'm moving into Stacey 7.12 in programming, even if Strider's going to argue with me, and I'm showing up as the star. I want you to show up as the star in your life too. So join the program, and I look forward to all you guys getting in touch with me with videos of your aligned walking or questions about how it's going with your yin yoga. And tell me about different aspects of you, different ways things are showing up in your life that's not causing the results that you want. Let's address them one step at an aligned step at a time. I mean, one aligned step at a time. I want diabetic jelly beans in my dressing room.